Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you are listening to Jengele Entertainment, you are daily welcome. Here we give you sizzling hot gist of what is trending in Nigeria, in Africa, and the world at large. If you are new in Amis, make sure you hit the subscribe button, the bell, and also the like so as to get the latest update on what is popping. We always keep you entertained. Lately, Davido has been trending in the bad side because he didn't win the Grammy Award. People have been criticizing him. There have been criticism on him that you didn't win the Grammy Award, Burna Boy won the Grammy Award, Wizkid won the Grammy Award. Like, they've been pushing Davido to the background. But the naked truth is that Davido is a nice guy. He has always been a nice guy. He's been dropping hits back to back. Recently, in an interview, Davido said he never collected one naira from Mayukun and other DMW artists. He just did everything for them for free. Davido is actually a nice guy. He has a good heart. Recently, Tenny was seen shouting at Davido. Tenny pleaded with him to be featured in her album, and Davido did just that. According to the message Tenny dropped behind the video, she said, "I love you, King Davido." Davido is actually a good guy. Just watch this video.
I swear to
you. David!
As you can see from that video, Tenny actually called on him. He stopped his car, the exchange number, and the album, the video is actually in Tenny's album, Wonderland. Also, fielding a question about how Davido was able to pull off so many international collaborations on his A Better Time album, the singer said it all stemmed from learning to build a relationship with foreign stars. Davido noted that for him, it's important to build a friendship first whenever he meets an international superstar before they get to making music or entertaining talks or collaboration. Davido has his bad side. He also has his good side. That is human being for you. Everybody has his good and bad side. And as I said earlier, they've been criticizing him lately that he didn't win the Grammy, neither was he nominated for the Grammy Awards. But Davido has been dropping hits. He's been dropping hits back to back. He featured Nicki Minaj and other international artists in his album, A Better Time. He has a good heart. That's the naked truth. And according to what he said earlier, everybody under his record label, I mean, he did everything for them for free. Mayukun, Peruzzi, to name but a few. I mean, Davido has been dishing out stores for free. He's actually a good. What do you think about this? Well, don't forget to drop your comments below. We've got so much to discuss about Wizkid, Davido, Burna Boy. We've got so much to discuss in entertainment. Recently, G Mike was seen singing a song. The song by Rick Hassani, Thunder Fire You. Someone must have offended Jim Ike to make him sing that song. I mean, come on. Well, just watch this video.
Thunder Fire You, for all the lies you told me. Thunder Fire You, for all you cheated on me. Thunder Fire You, you know you didn't deserve me. It no go better for you, Thunder Fire You and your friends.
Mm-hmm. Oh yeah.
Listen. You know too well.
Get person. You know.
You know where you came from, but when you came, tell the devil hello.
So what do you think about that? Will Jim I make a good musician? You know, so many actors and actresses have been going into music in Nigeria. Genevieve dropped an album, Omotola, Nkemowo, most of them dropped albums some years back anyway. And you can see Jim I doing his thing. Don't forget to drop your comments below. Will he make a better musician? He's actually a superb actor, no doubt about that, but will he make a better musician? Well, don't forget to drop your comments below. Starboy Entertainment boss Ayo Balogun, aka Wizkid, has been called out by a popular Twitter influencer, Samuel Limba, for not appreciating Recording Academy for his Grammy Award. The singer on Sunday bagged his first Grammy Award for Best Music Video with his contribution on Beyoncé's Brown Skin Girl off The Lion King, The Gift album released in 2019. And Wizkid hasn't said anything regarding that album. Fans have been criticizing Wizkid. People have been saying the guy is hard-hearted. He has this heart that is made of stone, that at least he would have said something. Appreciate people, like, thank you very much for your support. I mean, but Wizkid hasn't said anything. He's just sealed. His lips are sealed. He has not said anything. He has not congratulated anybody. He has not thanked anybody. He's just there. And people have been criticizing him. And from the look of things, Wizkid has been losing his fans. Because so many fans, people supporting Wizkid, they were just waiting to hear from him. Like, wow, thank you very much, my fans. Thank you. I mean, but Wizkid has not said anything. He has not even sent a message to the people that gave him the award, Recording Academy for the Grammy Award. Wizkid. This one is getting out of hand. Don't you think so? What do you think about that? Don't forget to drop your comments below. On the other side, Burna Boy's home state. You know, Burna Boy is from River State. Omalay is also from River State. Yeah, Burna Boy's home state plans to host the Grammy Award winner on the 27th of March, 2021. That will be on Saturday. Details will be released soon. And if those details have been released, I will definitely keep you posted. Still on Burna Boy. Burna Boy's grandfather, a former manager of Fela Kuti, in 2020 predicted that soon his son or his grandson will one day win the Grammy after losing it to Angelique Kujo. The veteran music critic is happy his prediction came true, and he is advising his grandson on what to do to stay on top of his game and bring home more Grammys. We are really waiting for more Grammys. We really want to see more Grammys from Burna Boy. He actually did very well. He did superb. I mean, winning a Grammy Award, and not just a Grammy, as in Best Global Album. That album is huge, twice as tall. As I've said earlier, if you haven't listened to that album, please download it and listen to it. I mean, he sent messages, you know, on that album. Yeah, and Burna Boy also dropped a tweet recently. He said, "I will never forget how so many of you prayed that I don't win," Burna Boy says in series of tweets. Burna Boy doesn't have fans like Davido and Wizkid. That is the naked truth. He has fans anyway. He has his own style of music. And people have been criticizing Burna Boy that he's proud, he's arrogant, he doesn't take, I mean, things lightly. If you give him A, he will give you A too. He doesn't have time for, let me be light-minded or something. No, he gives you what he can give you. He gives you what he gets. That's Burna Boy for you. That is his style. And so many people have been criticizing him. And according to Burna Boy, he said people have been praying that he doesn't win. And guess what? God didn't answer those prayers, actually. God answered Burna Boy's prayers because Burna Boy has won the Grammy. He wasn't a featured artist. No, he didn't win the Grammy as a featured artist. He won the Grammy as in his own album. And remember, recently Justin Bieber featured him in a track in his album Justice. The song is lit. Burna Boy has been doing very well. The album Twice as Tall is lit. Burna Boy has said he's the giant of Africa. We can't dispute that. He is the giant of Africa. That album alone, what he won in the Grammy Award, actually shows that he is the giant of Africa, because that album is huge. And guess what? Burna Boy's plaque, his Grammy Awards plaque, just has arrived Nigeria safely without crash. He has received his plaque as the winner of the Best Global Music Album. Congratulations to you, Burna Boy. Congratulations to you. You've been doing very well. You've been making Nigerians proud. Nigerians are actually proud of you. We can't stop appreciating you for painting Nigeria on the world map. We've been on the world map, that is the truth. But Burna Boy helped to paint us, in the music scene. He did very well. Well, let's move a little from music and talk politics a little. Let's discuss politics. the former Senate President Saraki begs Nigerians to give PDP another chance in 2023. He's saying, please, Nigeria, give PDP another chance in 2023, that PDP will do better than what APC is doing right now. That is Nigeria for you. That is politics for you. What are your takes on that? Well, don't forget to drop your comments below. Will you vote for PDP or APC in 2023? Did you enjoy PDP's government? Was PDP's government better than APC's or vice versa? What are your takes on that? Don't forget to drop your comments below. Still on politics, Governor Bala Muhammad has said, we have evidence Atiku defeated Buhari in 2019 election. And you haven't said anything, Mr. You didn't say anything for 2 years. This is 2021. You are now telling us in 2021 that you have evidence that Atiku defeated Buhari in 2019. And you are now telling us in 2021, Nigeria is a funny country. It's a very funny country. The Rivers State Governor, Nyesom Wike, took to BBC Pidgin about insecurity, politics, and the 2023 presidential election. According to him, he said PDP get malaria, but APC get cancer. I no go ever defect. According to Wike, he said PDP is far, far better than APC, because yes, you can treat malaria easily. You can treat malaria. Those of us in Nigeria, we know how to treat malaria. You can use agbo to treat malaria. But when it comes to cancer, my brother, you have to go the extra mile. Cancer is not easy to treat. And according to him, what we are having right now, what we have right now in this country is cancer. It's not just malaria. What do you think about that? Well, don't forget to drop your comments below. We're still in the music industry. So many persons have been complaining that other songs have not been selling in this country. No, we have good rappers in this country. We have MI, we have Vector, we have Ill Blaze. We have so many rappers. Olamide is there to mention a few. There's this new artist, Dan Dizzy. He's like crying out. According to Dan Dizzy, he says record labels avoiding rappers law that them no they sign rappers again. Everybody they find the next Wizkid. You won't blame record labels, bro. Everybody's looking for money. They want to make money, and Wizkid have been trending. Everybody wants the next Wizkid, the next Davido, the next Burna Boy. No rapper has ever won a Grammy Award in Nigeria, though they've been winning BET Award, winning the Headies Award and other awards, but Grammy, they've never been nominated for the Grammys. What do you say about that? Well, don't forget to drop your comment below. But I know we have good rappers in this country, superb rappers. I mean, they are going their extra miles, taking rap to the next level. The guy that actually started this rap is Mode9. Mode9 was actually doing very well in rap, but he didn't win any award. And according to what Mode9 said, he said he took rap to the next level, but he didn't make money from rap. James Brown and his other senior colleague, Bob Risky, they've been having this issue. Things have not been going lightly with them. Recently, James Brown came out and said he is more beautiful than Bob Risky. That Bob Risky doesn't do videos without filter. And James Brown actually showed himself that, okay, look at me, I did video without filter. I'm hotter, I'm sweeter, I'm finer than Bob Risky. Just watch this video.
Hey, darling, it's your girl, James Brown. I'm just curious, like more curious. Your auntie, Abi Auntie, whatever the person name is, said I am copying is or our content. The question I want to ask is that, has she ever or he ever do a video without filter? I'm just curious because I don't know if I'm copying the content or what. I don't know. Have you?
You've heard James Brown, that is his style. He has done his thing. According to him, he's fine, he's beautiful. Well, don't forget to drop your comments below on what you think about that. And it looks like all can not be well between Bob Risky and James Brown anytime soon. They were friends for a very short period of time, and all of a sudden, they'll be fighting each other. The cross-dresser has taken to social media, the cross-dresser, I mean Bob Risky, with a promise to get his name out of James's mouth. The cross-dresser too, Bob Risky has said, his junior colleague, James Brown, will hear from his lawyer, or her lawyer, or she lawyer. You know, sometimes I get confused on how to call Bob Risky because it's a him and a she at the same time. What are your takes on that? Don't forget to drop your comments below. Recently, there's this thing that has been trending. There's this picture that has been hitting the internet of somebody that looks like Buhari, and he was spotted driving on the street of Lagos. It's actually a taxi driver, and people just came like, Oga, he looked like Buhari. They were taking pictures of him. He couldn't help it. The man actually looks like Buhari anywhere. That's a negative, but he's not related to Mr. President. But at least on that, don't forget to drop a comment below. Thank you very much for watching Jungle Entertainment. We hope you are entertained. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button, the bell, and also the like, so as to get the latest update on what is trending in Nigeria and Africa and the world at large. We promise, and we will always lift our promise, to keep you updated with the times. Take care of you and have a lovely day.